Today's video, I am going to trace a curve that is y squared into 2a minus x is equal to x cube. And before going deep into it, and let me explain you the procedure how to trace the curve. And here, to trace a curve, there are certain properties which we have to follow. The first one is symmetry. Symmetric about x-axis. When we say that the given curve is symmetric about x-axis, the given curve is symmetric about x-axis if it has an even powers of y. So if it has even powers of y, we say that the given curve is symmetric about x-axis. And the next one is symmetric about y-axis. So the given curve is symmetric about y-axis if it has even powers of x. See here, if it has even powers of x, we say that this is symmetric about y-axis. And the next one is symmetric about both the axes. The given curve is symmetric about both the axes if it has even powers of x as well as y. See here, if we have even powers of both x and y, we say that the given curve is symmetric about both the axes. So if it has even powers of y, we say that it is symmetric about x-axis. If we have even powers of x, we say that it is symmetric about y-axis. If it has both even powers of x and y, we say that it's symmetric about both the axes. And the next one we have to check. The second point we have to check the origin. So put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. If the given equation satisfies the point 0, 0, then we say that the curve is said to be passing through origin. So if it's passing through origin, we have to calculate the tangent at origin. How to find out the tangent at origin? So we have to equate the lowest degree terms of the curve to 0. So if we equate the lowest degree term to 0, then we'll be getting the tangent at origin. The third step is asymptotes parallel to x-axis. So if you see that, what are asymptotes? Asymptotes are nothing but the parallel lines. If it's a curve, these are the asymptotes parallel to x-axis and these are the asymptotes parallel to y-axis. And let me show you, we have to show the asymptotes parallel to x-axis. Then we have to equate the quotient of highest degree terms of x to 0. Merely, it shouldn't be a constant. See here, if it's the case that is x cube is equal to y square. Here, the highest degree term is x cube. So, it's a constant. It shouldn't be a constant. So, here, if it's like this, then if we want the asymptote parallel to x-axis, so we have to equate the quotient of highest degree terms of x to 0, that is y minus a. Or is equal to 0 is an asymptote parallel to x-axis. So here, asymptote parallel to y-axis. How to find the asymptote parallel to y-axis? So here, the same case. So it shouldn't be a constant. So if it's a variable like this, for example, I'm taking. So if we want an asymptote parallel to y-axis, so we have to equate the quotient of highest degree term of y to 0, that is x minus a is equal to 0, is an asymptote parallel to y-axis. So the next point is points we have to gather. If we put x is equal to 0, we'll get y values. And if we keep y is equal to 0, we'll get x values. And after getting all the values, so we have to frame a figure here. And the next one is tangent. If dy by dx is equal to 0, the derivative itself is the tangent of the curve. And the next seventh step is rising and falling curve. If the derivative is positive, then we say that the curve is rising. If the derivative is less than 0, then we say that the curve is falling. If the derivative is equal to 0, then the curve is neither rising nor falling. And next one, concavity, convexity and point of inflection. If the double derivative is positive, then we say that the given curve is concave upwards and convex downwards. If the double derivative is less than 0, then we say that the given curve is concave downwards and convex upwards. If the double derivative is equal to 0, then we say that the curve has point of inflection. And using all these steps, I am going to trace the most important question here, that is y square into 2a minus x is equal to x cube. First, the step is symmetry. So it's very clear that we have even powers of y. Then we say that the curve is symmetric about x-axis since it has even powers of y. So in my procedure, I clearly said symmetric about x-axis, y-axis and both the axis. And for this tracing of curve, so we have even powers of y. We see that the given curve is symmetric about x-axis here. And the next one is origin we have to check. For the given equation, if we put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0, then it is very clear that the curve is passing through origin. So if it's passing through origin, we have to calculate the tangent at origin. So I clearly mentioned that for calculating the tangent at origin, we have to equate the lowest degree terms to 0. So this is the question here. So if I multiply, it will be 2ay square minus xy square is equal to x cube. So this is the highest degree, third degree, and this is also third degree. See here, 1 plus 2, this is 3 degree, and the least degree term is y square. So 2ay square is equal to 0, which implies that y square is equal to 0 is the tangent at origin. So the next one is asymptotes. So first of all, we have to find the asymptote parallel to y-axis. See here, if this is the question, so we have to equate the quotient of the highest degree term of y to 0. So here, equate the quotient of highest degree term of y to 0, so which is nothing but 2a minus x. So 2a minus x and x is equal to 2a is an asymptote parallel to y-axis. Coming to the asymptote parallel to x-axis, so here the quotient of highest degree term of x is merely a constant, so it shouldn't be a constant. Therefore, there are no asymptotes parallel to x-axis. See here. And the next one is points. So this is the question. So if we keep y is equal to 0, if we keep y is equal to 0, so I got the value of x as 0. And if we keep x is equal to 0, so I'll be getting the values of y as 0. And so here y is equal to 0. So only there is only one point. Origin is the only one point. And so this is the region, please remember, and this is the origin, and this is x is equal to 2a is an asymptote. See, I have to plot this asymptote, which is asymptote parallel to y-axis. So which is x is equal to 2a is an asymptote parallel to y-axis. I have plotted here, I have shown here. So x is equal to 2a is this straight line, and which is parallel to y-axis. So is an asymptote parallel to y-axis. And this is the figure. And the next one is tangent. Dy by dx is equal to 0 is the tangent of the curve and rising and falling curves. If the derivative is positive, we say that the curve is rising. If the derivative is less than 0, we say that the curve is falling. If the derivative is equal to 0, we say that it is neither rising nor falling. And the next one is concavity, convexity and the point of inflection. So for this, if the double derivative is greater than 0, then we see that the curve is concave upwards and convex downwards. If the double derivative is less than 0, then the curve is concave downwards and convex upwards. If the double derivative is equal to 0, then we see that the curve has point of inflection. And these are all the 8 steps which you have to follow. And please remember, so this is the most important topic, and first learn the procedure, and this coming to trace the curve, it will be very easy. And if you really like, just raise your thumb, leave a comment below and pass it on to your friends, and subscribe if you haven't still. Thank you so much for watching and staying till the end.